Good morning, students. Today I am going to teach you about the different parts of plant. A plant has different parts. They are as follows: root, shoot, stem, trunk, flower, bud, leaves, and fruits. Now I am going to tell you about each of the parts. So first I want to go to root. This is the part of the plant. So, root. Root is the part of the plant that always remains under the ground. जमीन के नीचे जो रहता है plant का भाग उसको हम root बोलते हैं. First I am going to tell about the root. Root of the plant is this that always remains under the ground. This is called root. And about the function of the root, I am going to tell you afterwards. Shoot. The parts of the plant that remains above the ground, it is called shoot. And this shoot contains different parts. This shoot contains stem, trunk, flowers, bud, leaves, and fruits. This is the part of the plant that remains above the ground that is called shoot, and it supports all the other parts of the plant. Now stem. What I am going to tell you about the stem. This is stem. Another name for the stem is also called trunk. It supports the parts of the plant and it carries all the water mineral from the soil and distributes to all the parts of the plant. Trunk. Trunk is the main of the part of the plant. It supports all the plants that bears different parts of plants like flowers, branches, stem, fruits, and bud. Flowers are attractive parts of the plants. They always help the plants to reproduce. And bud. Bud is like this, small. Again, later on, when bud develops, later on it develops into a flower. Leaves. A plant has different number of leaves. They are green in color and they help the plant to prepare their own food. What do we call their process? Okay, we call it photosynthesis. How do the leaves prepare food for the plants? Leaves. This is a leaf. And this leaf contains green substance. That green substance is known as chlorophyll. And underneath of the leaves, there are thousands of pores, small pores that we cannot see. They are known as stomata. The small pores. When we see the underneath of the leaf, with the help of a microscope, we can see very tiny pores. And these tiny pores trap the sunlight. And leaves, I have already told you that the leaves contain chlorophyll. And from the root, okay, from the root, that all the mineral water is absorbed up. And that stem and branches carries to different parts of the plant. When these combine together, sunlight, these leaves trap the sunlight, plus chlorophyll, plus water mineral. Student, listen, I have already told you that these leaves, with the help of chlorophyll, get trap the sunlight and throw the food away. It gets water and mineral. When sunlight, chlorophyll, water mineral is combined together, sugar is produced. You know the name for sugar is also called glucose. This is the food for the plant. And this is the food for the plant that is produced in the leaves. That's why we call the leaves the kitchen for the plants, because food for the plants is prepared in the kitchen. When the food, glucose or sugar, is prepared in the leaves, okay, that is carried to the different parts of the plant, okay, through the stem and branches. And that food is used by the plants, okay, for the growth, to repair the damaged cells and etc. Now I am going to teach you about fruits. This is food from plant, okay, that helps the plants reproduce, because it has seed. In a fruit, okay, there is seed, okay, some fruits have single seed and some fruits have many seeds, and these seeds help the plant to reproduce. When we sow this seed in the soil, and when it gets the suitable temperature, soil and water mineral, okay, it grows into a new plant. Now, types of root, okay. I have already told you that the root is the part of the plant that remains under the ground. So, there are two kinds of root. Mainly, there are two kinds of root. One is tap root, another is high root. Tap root. This type of root, tapping root, which goes deep into the soil, okay, it goes deep into the soil. Right? To absorb the water mineral from the ground, so this type of root is known as tap root. And the plants that have tap roots are bean mustard. And this first plants have taproot. Okay? It is long time, it goes deep into the soil and it absorbs water and mineral. But this taproot, now fibrous root is quite different from taproot. The taproot has the main root, but fibrous roots do not have main roots. It is just like this. It is to all the direction. It does not have the main root. This type of fibrous type of root is called fibrous root. And these are just like thread-like roots. Okay, different. And number of thread like structure, and the plants that have fibrous roots are grass types. Examples of the fibrous root: grass, and these plants have fibrous root.
the function of the root, I told you that the main function of the root is to absorb water and mineral from the ground and to supply to the different parts of the plant. But you have to keep in mind that some of the roots like carrot, turnip and mooli, that is, they store food in them. Now stem. The part of the plant that grows, this is soil. The part of the plant that grows above the ground, okay, and that grows from the main trunk, okay, that is called stem. The main function of stem is to support the plant above the ground, and apart from that, okay, stem also carries and transport the food prepared in the leaves to different parts of the plant. I have already told you that the leaves are called the kitchen of the plants, because food for the plants is prepared in the leaves. So that food, that glucose and that sugar has to go to different parts of the plant for the growth, to repair cells, to repair dead and damaged cells. So stem does that function. Stem carries the food to the different parts of the plant from top to bottom. Now kinds of plants. According to the size and shape of the plants, okay, plants are classified into different categories. They are herbs, very small plants with weak stems, very small plants with weak stems that grow in the soil are called herbs, but they are very weak. They do not have trunk, they do not have branches. They are very small plants. Example of herbs are grass, and these shrubs. Shrubs are medium-sized plants. They are bigger than herbs, but smaller than trees. Okay? They are woody. Okay? They are woody. Rose plant. Mint plant. They come in this category, shrubs. Okay? They are known as shrubs. They are medium-sized plants. Now trees, you know the definition of trees. Trees are very big plants, very big, strong and woody plants. They have different type of, okay, they have different type of parts. Climbers are the weak plants that cannot stand erect on the ground. They are very weak plants. They need support to climb or to walk. Okay? They need support. Without support, okay, they cannot walk. These are called climbers. These plants are very weak. They cannot stand on their own. Without support, they cannot stand on their own. Creepers. Creepers are also very weak plants, okay, with weak stems like climbers, but they creep along the ground. Okay? They spread like this. Okay? They creep along the ground. Their stem is also very weak. Okay? Watermelon. Pumpkin. This watermelon and pumpkin are the right examples of creepers. Yeah, climbers, I forgot to give you the examples of climbers. Yeah, pea and bean are the examples of climbers. Ma'am, I am going to tell you about the function of the different parts of the plant. Now children, students, you have already known the different parts of plants, okay, according to their size. Now I am going to tell you about the function of the parts of the plants. First, leaves. Leaves, without leaves, any plants cannot survive. It is impossible for the plants to survive without plant, without leaves, because leaves, okay, I have already told you that leaves are considered as the kitchen of the plants. Okay, all the food in the leaf, all the food for the plants that is kept in the leaves, and leaves has a leaf has. It contains chlorophyll. Because of the chlorophyll, okay, all the leaves are, all the plants are green in color. So when we see the underneath of the plants, underneath of the leaves, okay, we can see tiny pores, they are stomata. And when this, with the help of stomata, sunlight is trapped in the leaves, and with the help of the leaves, okay, with the help of the stomata, a plant also breathe carbon dioxide. When carbon dioxide cross when carbon dioxide sunlight chlorophyll cross watermelon is combined, okay, food for the plants is prepared in the leaves. So that is carried by the stem, with the help of stem, that food is carried to different parts of plant. I have already told you the function of root, stem. Now I am going to tell you about the different parts of the leaf. This is a leaf and it has also different parts. It has different parts. This main leaf line, this main leaf line is called main vein. This is main vein. You can clearly see when you take a leaf and observe it clearly, okay, you can see
nine veins should come here to there. Okay, this is called main vein. And small pores that we cannot see with our naked eyes. Stomata. This is side vein. All the veins that grow from the main vein, okay, and one side vein. This all side vein. This side vein. And the outer covering of the vein, outer this. Outer covering, only outer covering. This is called lamina. The outer covering of the where that gives shape to a leg is called lamina. Moreover, plants, I have told you that some. Roots of the plants store food. Yeah. The examples of the plant, the examples of the roots there store food. Carrot, radish, and turnip. They store foods. And likewise, some plants also store their food, okay, in the leaves. When the food is excess, some plants store their food in the leaves so that they can use afterwards. The plants that store their extra food in the leaves where they are no less carries reduce. These plants store their extra food in the leaves. Flowers. Before also I have told you about the flowers. These are the most attractive parts of the plant. They are beautiful and they are colorful. Okay. And some of the flowers, they have pleasant smell and they attract insects. You must have seen that honeybee visiting flowers to collect nectar from them, and some butterflies and other insects are also attracted by flowers because they are beautiful, they are colorful. And some flowers, okay, they help plants to reproduce. After a certain period of time, flowers develop into fruits. And you know that fruits are the parts of the plants that always help the plants to reproduce. Because inside the fruits, okay, they contain seed. Some fruits contain only single seed, and some fruits contain more than single seed. Mango, and apricot, okay, they contain single seed, while others, okay, pineapple, and apples, okay, they contain more than one seed, and these help the plants to reproduce. Fruits have seed in them. These seeds grow into new plant. How do you think that the seeds grow into new plants? When the seeds grow, yes. This is seed. It certainly grows into a new plant. But when a seed gets the suitable temperature, the suitable soil, okay, water and mineral, then only, okay, it is possible for a seed to grow into a new plant. Okay, that process is called seeding.
when a seed link the depth goes gets the right condition, okay, then only it goes into a new plant, okay, that process is called seedling. Some fruits have single seed like mango, apricot and plum, and other fruits like orange, apple and lemon have more than single seed. Some seeds are used for food. They can be eaten. They are edible. Okay. They are used as a food in our daily life. Okay. The seeds that can be eaten, that are edible, that can be used as food are grams. Peas. The seeds of these plants are edible. Okay, they can be used as food in our daily life. Seeds have some food issue in them. These seeds also, okay, these grams, peas, wheat and rice and the seeds of other plants, okay, they also eat some food. Okay, the first when plants uses this food to grow, later when the leaves appear, it starts making its own food. Okay. The growth of a seed into a baby plant is called germination. Children, I have taught you today the different parts of the plant and their functions. If you are in confusion, if you have not understood anything, okay, you are free to, okay, ask me. I am always ready to give my helping hand. So for the same way, WhatsApp number is given. Okay, in the WhatsApp number you can send your queries and any questions. What you have not understood, what you are in confusion in. Thank you.